I'm Don Ryder, and I wanted to share with you something I've been working on. This is the Mad Genius motion capture system. It allows you to add motion and location-sensitive control to any console or PC game, even if the game was not originally written for motion control. This video will show the system with Skyrim on an Xbox 360 console. I did not modify the Xbox or the Skyrim software in any way. Here the player leans to the left and to the right, and also forward and back. The system tracks her motion and moves the character in the game according to her movement. She is not using the analog control for this. To move further, she walks in front of the television. The system tracks her again and moves the game character exactly with her movement as she walks around the room. This is possible because the motion capture system knows exactly where the controller is in the room. It can even detect when the player jumps and make the game character jump as well. Now the player wants to shoot the bow. She separates the controller into two halves and simulates holding a bow. The motion capture system sees this motion and sets up the game so that she can shoot the bow. Boxes are drawn in space based on where the controller is split in half. When the player touches these boxes, the controller activates the bow and aims by tracking the player's hand. The controller automatically opens the favorites menu, scrolls to the bow, loads it, and closes the favorites menu of the game. She didn't have to push a single button for this. Now, she aims the bow in the game by moving her hands as if she was holding and aiming a bow in real life. The system tracks her movements precisely and aims the bow in the game. She aims at a target and shoots. She can hit even very small targets on the screen due to the unprecedented accuracy of the motion tracking. Even while the player is holding and aiming the bow, other motions can be used to trigger game events. Here she bumps with the left controller to strike an enemy with the bow. With the bow still drawn, she walks towards the television. The system sees this motion and makes the game character walk forward as well until she's at the end of the platform looking down on the town below. Now she's shooting very small targets at a distance. This is only possible because the system sees even the smallest motions and uses them to aim the bow. The controller can do this because it knows exactly where each controller half is in the room. The system can trigger game events by where the controllers are held by the player. It can also trigger game events by gestures and motions that the player makes. Looking over her shoulder, we can see the tracking accuracy. The response is immediate. There's no delay between the player's movement and the game's response. If she moves even a 32nd of an inch, the aim of the bow changes. The accuracy is so high that for shooting very small targets, she has to hold her breath before shooting. Breathing moves her hand far enough that the system sees this motion and moves the bow. This adds to the experience of the game. If you've ever fired a bow in real life, you know that you have to do exactly the same thing. Now that she's finished with the bow, she rejoins the two halves of the controller. The system sees that she's done this and knows that she wants to put the bow away. All she had to do was to put the controller halves back together. The system automatically opens the favorites menu, unloads the bow, and loads the same sword and shield that she had before she used the bow. She uses her right hand to swing the sword. Moving faster will swing the sword harder. She can raise the shield by holding her left hand higher. When she puts her left hand down, the character lowers the shield. Crossing wrists opens the favorites menu. She can scroll through the favorites by moving her left hand left and right. The controller supplies all the button pushes necessary to move through the favorites. Bumping her right hand up selects a weapon. Bumping down closes the favorites menu and returns to the game. She now has the Warhammer. She swings it by moving her right hand. To block, she raises her left hand high. There is a long list of motions and gestures that can be used to trigger game events. Here, she changes the game view from third person to first person by touching the left controller to her forehead. Touching the controller to her forehead again changes back to the third person view. Another motion with the left hand can change the game from normal mode to stealth mode. The same motion again changes the game back to normal mode. This is the brains of the motion control system. These processors do all the tracking and interpretation of the player's motions. I'm using a PC to display the controller tracking, but a PC is not required to use the motion capture system with your game console. Now we can see the motion capture system in action in actual gameplay. All of the normal controller buttons are still active. She can choose to use the motion control or the controller buttons or any combination of the two anytime she wants. She's using the analog sticks for running long distances while also using her own movement to move around during combat. She's coordinating the sword and shield using only the motion controller. Now watch this part. She'll use the sword and shield together in combat. Now she's raised the shield with her left hand. When she motions with the right hand, she bumps her enemy with the shield. When she lowers her left hand, the character drops the shield and she attacks with the sword. Her character was bitten by a werewolf in the past. Now she's changing into a werewolf. She raises both hands above her head and the controller reconfigures itself to control the werewolf character. Now, when she motions with the right hand, the werewolf slashes with its right claw. When she motions with the left hand, the werewolf slashes with the left claw. Again, she's using analog sticks for moving large distances and using the movement tracking to move around during combat.
From here, this sounds totally badass. I can't see a thing on the screen, but...
So that's a quick look at some of the things that the Mad Genius motion capture system can do. This is just the proof of concept prototype. A finished version would be much prettier and neater. The purpose here is to show what's possible. Remember that no changes were made to the game console or to the game software. Everything was done by the motion controller. This means that you can add motion control to any game on any console, no matter how old. You can dig up a 10-year-old game and play it all over again with motion capture, and it's a brand new game.